I think that we down here on this end of the building. I made a paper template to mark where I was going to put my holes and was able to drill through that. Template worked out good. Once we got the beam up, we had to make a few adjustments to reset the holes. Some of them did not line up. About to take the drill bit and drill straight through the wood and through the beam over again to get the holes lined up. But it came out pretty good. It's going to support the indoor batting net. Now here again, we're going to make our markings. Somebody's persistent with this phone.
Mm-hmm. Watch you, man.
I'm about to shut down today.
Spot.
We may have one more plate to mark. We got that one taken care of. We're going to go back down here. So from this point now where he's holding, all the way down here, we have 10 feet. That you're two professionals.
Oh. Hey, this is my start in my YouTube career. More to come. More to come.
It's gonna be easier to set these plates by marking the size of them. Everything's lined up. We have our hole marked and we have our size marked. And this is the whole plate here looking good. Ready to mount. Okay, we have our steel plate all measured out here. And we tuck in, use our punch to get it a hole started. Got four sections here. Just took a hammer and punched it in. This is for to hang this flat steel beam here. It's required when you're hanging the batting cage for one end at least. Got all the brackets attached. For the other end, we got our measurements in on the same thing. Punched here and here. Got four holes to drill out there. How thick it is. It's about 1 inch. And this is how long it is. On the other end of the building here, of the warehouse, it's where we hung the wooden one. There we attached the two beams together. That's on the other end. And that was heavy also, but this is even more heavier. The steel. And on this end of the building, we're going to put our steel beam from that corner all the way to the other beam on this end. So I need to get up there and drill those four holes for my bolts. I have to drill on this beam also. So we're working on that. Okay, I have 5 bits I'm going to use. I think they used 7 before. We're going to try 5 and work our way up. Gotta put the 2x4 under here to keep that from moving. And we're gonna start here. Make sure you have your safety glasses on. Just gonna continue to do my other 4 holes with the same bit. Get my bit in oil. Try the next hole. We already got them punched out with our punch.